You saw them shake hands. They're out there for round 10. George Foreman in the blue trunks, or the dark trunks if you're in black and white. And Peralta in the white trunks or the light trunks. The only sign of blood in the fight was Foreman's blood. Crowd yells as Peralta lands on the right, as Peralta attempts to buffet Foreman with a couple of more rights. Foreman's blood above the right eye, a minor slit, never amounted to anything up to this point. Best round in the fight for Foreman, the ninth round, the one just over. We're in the tenth. We have about 2 minutes left in the fight. Scoring on a round system, supplemental point system if the rounds are even. This is a town for underdogs. It's the city of the Mets and the city of the Jets, and they love to see the underdog come on. Looks really tired to this report. Really tired. He is doubtless in the lead in the scoring, but you never really know. The fight is not that widely disparate. And right combination to the head, drawing upon inner resources, trying to end it if he can. Less than a minute left in the fight. That, in fairness to Foreman, he was off balance. He was not hit, he was not hurt. Crowd yelling because of their feeling for the underdog. Even before the heavyweight championship fight. Ten seconds left in the bout. The roars of the crowd speak for themselves as the referee and the judges have rendered their decision. Now Johnny Addy.
Johnny Castellano, 5-4, one even, Foreman. Jack Foreman, 7-3, Foreman.
Winner by a unanimous decision. The crowd booing that decision, booing it vociferously. I'm going into the ring to talk with George.